We first told you about the sudden death of the president of Roger Williams University last night. New tonight, we're talking with university CFO on the legacy of Donald Farish and what he leaves behind. Eyewitness News reporter Alexandra Leslie is in our control room now with how Dr. Farish is being remembered tonight.
The university's CFO spoke to Eyewitness News this morning. He called Farish a visionary for Roger Williams, known the most for caring so much about his students.
Thursday, Roger Williams University announced the sudden passing of its 10th president, Donald Farish. At 75 years old, Farish died of a sudden and serious illness.
The reputation of Roger Williams University is stronger because of President Farish being here.
Jerome Williams, the university's CFO, spoke to Eyewitness News about the legacy Farish has left behind.
He was a visionary for Roger Williams. He moved the university forward. He was so student-centered.
So much so, Williams tells us, you could always find him at open houses, accepted Students Day, and even various presentations or sports events. It's his accessibility, Williams said, that he'll be known for, too.
He was always interested in hearing what the students thought. And, you know, it's encouraging to see that. You want to make sure that you're listening to the campus, and that's one of the greatest attributes that he had.
Another way he showed his appreciation for students was making sure an education was affordable. Farish appeared on Executive Suite in 2012 with Ted Nisi discussing those plans.
A new model is necessary for higher education, and I think it's going to come from the private sector, not the public sector.
And for years, the tuition remained the same at Roger Williams.
He cared deeply about making sure that higher education was an affordable means for everybody. It's a sad day for the university. He was deeply loved by everyone at the university, and we will miss him greatly.
Farish was planning to retire in June 2019 when his contract expired. The university says they're giving the family privacy at this time, but memorials are, of course, in the works. Reporting in the control room, Alexandra Leslie, Eyewitness News.